Center, the free dance continues. Belbin and Augusto from the U.S. have the lead. And on the ice right now, the 2005 U.S. bronze medalists, Lydia Manon and Ryan O'Meara, in a great position in third place after the original dance, trying to do something special here at an ISU championship. A little less than 7 points out of second place right now. Like Belbin and Augusto, the airline lost their luggage, including their skates, and it didn't arrive at their hotel until the first day of competition here in Korea. Unnerving, to say the least.
Fine and polished. One thing to note about this team is their posture. Very strong through the back, secure skating, always getting the best glide out of the blade. The continuation of movement.
Suzy is one of the best ice dancers that the U.S. has ever produced. You shake your head and get a kick out of the fact that here we are at an ISU international event and the U.S. has a chance to sweep and dance?
Well, of course, because it's been a long time coming. There have always been talented ice dancers in the U.S. because of politics, may not have been able to advance where they should be, but the ice dancing program has, as a whole, increased at the junior level and at the senior level. There's more strength, more numbers.
This team, along with Gregory Impechikov, who will be up next, will carry the burden for the U.S. at the Olympics next year, because Belbin and Augusto most likely will not be eligible. So I'm sure not only is there excitement, but a little added pressure, feeling that you have to take it up a notch.
In talking with these skaters throughout the season, no one wants to get to the Olympics by default. They want to be able to perform and really show their stuff. The unison not as strong compared to that of Belbin and Augusto's in these turns. And these are little places where you can start to lose points by not having that unison and security and turns and difficulty in the footwork. It seems as though everyone's really getting comfortable with the harder lifts. When you have a highlight move, it's kind of fun and as a skater to perform that. And the footwork is much harder. Speed on their final footwork, but they'll need to show different methods of turning just to show that they have that ability to turn on different edges in different ways. And they're certainly capable. Their final lift. A little problem there on the transition. A team that has impressed me in their skating skill, the way they work with one another. They really have a great start. They haven't had the experience compared to Belbin and Augusto. It'll be fun to watch them develop throughout the years.
Lydia Manon, who is from Delaware. Ryan O'Meara, who is from Scottsdale, Arizona.
This very strong lift, beautiful extension through her legs. He has great control on this inside spread eagle. Watch his back, very controlled and powerful. And then he changes curve. There's a lot of leverage there and a lot of control between them. This is a difficult lift. It cartwheels in. She has like a self-supported split position. And now they're going to change and transition in a different curve and a different rotation. A little bit rushed, so he has to adjust and his feet come apart. Those little Mohawk turns need to be really close, but he saved that and compensated very well.
The scores please for Lydia Manon and Ryan O'Meara from USA.
So, Lydia Manon, or Manon, if you're in South Korea, along with Ryan in the Kiss and Cry now. There's a score to beat. Folks, they're not going to approach that, but they're trying to medal at an ISU championship, which would be a first for them. So the free dance total, 85.40. Their overall total, 171.65. And this was really an important trip over to Korea for them.
This is the start, really, of their international experience. Can